In this problem, we want to calculate the entropy change. If we start out with water that we were able to cool down to minus 25 degrees C while maintaining it as a liquid. However, when we perturb this system, then it's going to go to equilibrium. Water at minus 25 degrees C as a liquid is not an equilibrium state. And the question is, what's the entropy change for this process? We need to first determine what's the final state, and then we need to pick a pathway that we can calculate the entropy change. So normally as we cool water down, we expect at 0 degrees C, if we're at equilibrium, to start freezing it as we remove energy. But it's possible to cool it below 0 degrees C without it freezing. However, once it's perturbed, then it's going to rapidly go to equilibrium. And so we could represent the process, and equilibrium, of course, is at 0 degrees C. Let's draw a representation of the process first. So in this diagram, now I've represented it. We start at minus 25 degrees C as a liquid. We're going to be at 0 degrees, and the question is, what's the amount of liquid and solid? Because we've taken energy out from water to cool it below 0 degrees C, which means if we had taken an equilibrium approach, we'd have frozen some of that liquid. So we can imagine the process being some pathway we don't know, that we're going to end up somewhere in between. We follow some pathway. But what we're going to do is pick a pathway that we can calculate the entropy change for. Entropy is a state function, so we can pick a pathway that makes the calculations easy. And what we're going to take as a basis is 1 gram of our starting liquid water. Delta H for the actual process is going to be 0 because we're going to assume Q is 0 because this process happens fast. So once it's initiated very quickly, we're going to have this ice liquid mixture. The heat transfer is therefore 0, delta H is 0, and delta H consists of delta H1 and delta H2, state function. So again, we can pick a pathway that makes our calculations easier. So the overall change in enthalpy, first law, is 0 because Q is 0, there's no work. And that's delta H1 plus delta H2. So delta H1 is just a sensible heat, a heat capacity times a temperature difference. And delta H2 is the enthalpy of fusion with a minus sign, where enthalpy of fusion would be for melting. Positive, we want a negative value, delta H. We have to take energy out to freeze it. And X will represent the fraction of a gram that we freeze. So this is the fraction that's frozen when we're at equilibrium. So let's substitute in the heat capacity, the temperature difference. The final temperature is 0. The initial temperature is minus 25. X is our unknown, and this temperature change is Kelvin, because a change in Kelvin, a change in centigrade, the same thing, a delta value. So this is minus 334 joules per gram. Delta H of fusion is the energy we have to put in to melt, so it's negative when we're freezing. So we can solve for X, which is going to be dimensionless, it's just a fraction, and it's going to equal 0.31. So our final state then is a mixture of solid and liquid, 0.31 grams of solid and 0.69 grams of liquid. The entropy change then, again, is the entropy change for process 1 plus entropy change for process 2. If we want to calculate the entropy change total, then we would include entropy change of the surroundings. Because the process is fast, Q is 0, no work done, no entropy change for the surroundings. Entropy change for heating up the liquid is integral Cp dt over T from, and to be careful, we should use, since we have to use Kelvin in this calculation, I'm going to write the limits. And then the enthalpy change for phase change divided by the temperature is the entropy change, the phase change at constant temperature in the pathway we'd picked. And so we can calculate then by first integrating. So the total entropy change would be the heat capacity, the log of the final temperature, the initial temperature in Kelvin. Delta H is X times minus 334 divided by the temperature, which is 273. So this is 4.18. And then X is 0.31. So I've substituted the numbers in, and therefore the total entropy change is 0.02 joules per gram per Kelvin. Important to point out this is positive because this is an irreversible process, and we calculate the total entropy change. So the system plus the surroundings, total entropy change should be greater than zero.